The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st Canto, 2nd Chapter, Text Number 21, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on November 1st, 1972, in Vrindavan, India.
Vidyate Hridaya Granthi Siddhante Sarvasamsaya Chiyante Cha Asya Karmani Drishta Eva Atmani Ishar. This is complete liberated stage. In the previous verse, it has been spoken Bhagavat Tattva Vijnanam Mukta Sangasya Jayat. The science of God, Bhagavat Tattva, the science of absolute truth, becomes manifest to the liberated soul. We find sometimes that one man is posing to have very much advanced in spiritual understanding or a great devotee, but mukta sangha, he is not mukta sangha. He cannot give up smoking biri. You see? These are the small tests. One who has actually tasted spiritual life, his unwanted things of life would at once diminish. There is no need. Anartha nivittishya. Anartha. Anartha, things which are not wanted, which has no meaning. So, mukta sangha means no material attachment. That is mukta sangha. When one is actually liberated, these are the signs. Vidyante Hridaya Granthi. Our material life begins by a knot in the heart. What is that knot? That is sex desire. This is the knot. A man is hankering after a woman, and a woman is hankering after a man. This attachment is the beginning of material life. Everyone, not only human society, in animal society, in bird society, in beach society, will find this sex attachment. This is the Hridaya Granthi, beginning. Therefore, according to Vedic civilization, the first teaching to a student is to give him lesson how to become brahmachari, how not to become attached in sex life. That is called brahmachari. Tapasa brahmacharyena. Tapasa, to become brahmachari, to become abstinent from sex life, it requires tapasa. It is not so easy thing. Tapasa brahmacharyena. Damena samena. One has to practice how to control the mind, how to control the senses. This is brahmacharya. Tapasa, it requires tapasa. At the present moment, the students were to speak of tapasa. They are given all kinds of lectures. So how there will be brahmachari? It is not possible. Especially in the Western countries, the boys and girls, they are educated in one place, co-education, and they live in the same building. And there are so many things you know better than me. So there is no brahmachari. There is no brahmacharya. That means the knot in the heart, sex desire, is more and more increased. It is not decreased. But if one takes to Krishna consciousness by practice, one comes to the point of giving up all these unwanted things. Chiddanti, Vidanti, Hridaya Granthi. I have several times explained to you that this knot of the heart is the sex desire. Pungshang Sriya Mithuni Bhava. Sex desire Mithuni Bhava Metha. Kayo Hridaya Granthi. And when they are actually united, that knot becomes more and more tight. But if one takes to Krishna consciousness, then gradually Vidyante Hridaya Granthi, that knot, sex desire, that is the test whether one's sex desire has diminished. That is the test. Vidyante Hridaya Granthi. Vidyante Hridaya Granthi Chiddante Sarva Sangshaya. Sangshaya. We are now in hazy conclusion. What is our position? We do not know. We do not know what is God, what I am, what is our relationship. Everyone is speculating. Therefore there are so many parties. The Jnani party, the Yogi party, the Karmi party, generally, and within each and every party there are hundreds and thousands of parties. So when one actually becomes free from the knot, or the knot is cut off, the attachment for material desires is cut off, at that time he can understand what is his position. What is his position? Therefore, two things must go on in parallel line. One side, a person should cultivate Krishna consciousness, and another side, he should try to give up all the unwanted things that will help him. You cannot continue both the things. Just like when a person is diseased, he is given medicine. At the same time, he has to act, not to take this, not to take that. That is the way of treatment. Whatever you like, can eat, whatever you like, can do, at the same time, you become spiritually advanced. This is all nonsense. Tapasya brahmacharya. One has to practice tapasya. Tapa. Means a little inconvenience, voluntary accepting inconvenience. That's like brahmachari lying down on the floor. A sannyasi also, they follow the same practice as far as possible, taking bath thrice daily. And so many rules and regulations are there, but at the present day, it is not possible to follow all the rules and regulations, but at least everyone who is interested in advancing in Krishna consciousness must rise early in the morning, before 4, and take his bath and become cleansed. Perform Mangalaratri and study. These are tapasya. Tapasya brahmacharjena samena dhamenava. Tyagena. Tyagena means renouncement. I like something, but voluntarily I should give it up. That is called tyag. Of course, one who takes to Krishna consciousness seriously, Krishna helps him to become qualified in these matters.